Eliot, thank you for coming to this performance of Paul's piece, Spudnut. Please make sure that you've switched off your mobile phone. If you don't, we'll force you to buy some of Justin's double glazing. Anyway, hope you enjoy the show. Said it began as a bedtime story to keep the children of the village sweet. You best be good as gold now, girl, or the Owl Man of Morning will come for you.
My care. Treatments have radically improved since then. bastard.
Mrs. Pussy! Mrs. Pussy! What's that?
It's Nancy.
Nancy?
Aye. Virgil's twin.
Twin?
Oh, she never made it out like that rancid bastard did.
He's a reabsorption. I've read about the phenomenon, but never seen it with my own eyes.
You know, Nancy's always been my favourite. Virgil was always so jealous of Nancy. That's why I tried to cut her out to me. Scoop her out like she were ice cream. But she's mine, you know. She's my little girl.
I think I'm just going to get some air.
Don't let me eat out.
I need to breathe.
Sit down.
Sure, we can listen to Credence. River.
I like Mardi Gras. That's a great record.
Mardi Gras? What the hell are you talking about? That's like their worst album.
It is?
Yes. Tensions in the band met Tom Fogerty's split, leaving John, Doug Clifford, and Stu to forge on regardless. The result was mediocre at best. And because it wasn't even a full lineup, you can't even really call it the Creedence record.
You don't get up much, do you, Jerry?
Hello, Jerry.
Lieutenant Recover Cron. We're coming to go. I didn't hear you come in.
Please, Jerry, you just can't play out.
Really?
Well, we're all friends down here. Just go ahead and call me Nina. And what is this the result of?
Well, Leia.
Nina.
Leia. That's one drop of O-ethyl S2-diisopropylamino-methylfolate.
VX. What's VX?
It's the short name for O-ethyl S2-diisopropylamino-methylfolate. Wait a second. Are you telling me that O-ethyl S2-diisopropylamino-methylfolate has a shorter name?
Yes, Jerry. VX.
Ding. I wish I would have known that sooner. I would have spent a heck of a lot of time talking to birds.
Mm-hmm.
You'll be pleased to know that this delightful Cold War vintage still kills things horribly.
Attacks the nervous central system, doesn't
it? Impairs the vision, eviscerates the lungs, results in agonizing death. Pretty hokey stuff.
And that's the wars at the ice skating for you.
10 times more toxic than most G agents.
Seems to remember that I tried it as a pesticide.
That's what it is, compound organophosphate. If the funding dries up, you can sell it around to the local farmers around here for crop spray.
We tried that already.
I was joking.
No, we sold it to South Africa to kill creepy crawlies on grapevines. They then shaped the grapes back to us. But that was before we discovered it was better used as a chemical weapon. But we've covered our tracks now, and all the coolie people have gone away.
And what else are they making to test here?
Oh, working down one's results on everything you have stockpiled here.
That's a frightfully long list, Jimmy.
Oh, you know me. I look to you.
Trioxy-432.
Be careful with that, Nina. The housing's a little loose.
And what does this make you do?
Oh, inhalation, it drives you insane. Completely and utterly insane.
Oh, wait, science, that's exciting.
It's a prototype. It's never been used in the field. Vietnam's the closest it came to.
It's like an American recipe, like how much good old homemade apple pie.
What, do I owe the pleasure of your company?
We have some rather distressing news. We've hit a snag. Environmental coming down was hard there.
Clean up.
Hey, Alfred, any fast movers?
All fixed in plenty, just do.
Thanks. You were saying?
We're being shut down, Jerry.
What?
The harbour and test area is becoming called manufacture. It's now becomes illegal in international law. We need to buy a kite premises immediately, and here's why it comes from here. We were supposed to stop manufacturing nerve gases with the IE.
But we haven't.
No, Jerry, we have not. And with these testicles, I'm going to cite all the evidence of production. For all the clients, we're all for the job.
Hide the evidence.
Get rid of everything immediately.
Everything?
Everything.
But the dumps are at capacity. We can't bury anymore on site.
Then we'll have to think of some other alternative.
Me?
You know you're lucky.
Well, I wouldn't say that. I have plenty of dead birds for friends, and you said I could surf here? That's why I came to this shithole. I was promised. Great surf!
Surfing, Jerry, is not the prime concern here. The prime concern is the chemical capability of this country can boast in the event of another war.
I know. But I haven't been allowed out since I got here. I haven't seen a goddamn sun, let alone hang 10 on my longboard.
Do this one thing, I'm gonna raise you.
You'll let me go surfing?
You'll be back to sunny California with great benefits and pension before you can say... What do surfers say, Jerry?
Cowabunga?
Yeah, cowabunga. But we've got to work with it. The quicker the better.
Transport by road. Seal it in here.
Environment on the place left empty.
Shit. Think.
Sorry, Jerry. Can you hear us in there?
weapons plant we're talking about. Things get said all the time, right?
All you treat my word on this discretion.
Do you like your job?
I like having a job. If I was a farmer, but I didn't take sillage. If you don't take sillage around here, there ain't much else to choose from.
So local town, are you going?
You can get me a side.
Whereabouts? Where are you from?
You seen that house that stands alone onto the cliff on West Bend?
No. But I can picture it in my mind's eye.
That's been a place for six generations. I was born it right on the kitchen floor.
Yeah, I have this office here.
How else is this?
Yeah, he's on our land, you know.
This land is owned by the farmers. I've been one of them. When you fellas moved them,
we repositioned it.
You did.
And we allowed you to keep your homes, didn't we, boy?
You did, honey. You need to take it away. You wouldn't do that, would you? If I was said a deal was struck, they shook on it.
Oh, wow, if
they shook on it. Freaking me out, man.
We are presenting you with a solution to your problem, Terry.
What problem?
See, then you want to go surfing.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Say, Leia!
Nina.
I know this facility has met its untimely end at the nerve gas factory, but this will remain MOD property, right? And ain't you gonna need a skeleton staff to keep things kicking over?
You mean someone who can keep a close eye on things once they're packed up and gone?
Precisely.
And who do you suggest, right?
Why, Alfred here would be great. What about Alfred?
Alfred Floyd.
Oh, that sounds
great. Lay it here, we'll see how it's done.
Just like that.
Just like that.
Just like that.
Just like that.
Thank you, Jerry. And mom, I need to drive soon.
Sounds like you.
Gee, thanks, Nita.
That's an eternal kind of crime to you, Jerry.
Gently, in the early stages of the integration. Fantasies.
find his endangered sense of security, the malignant force that took his father away. He feared if he saw the beast, it meant that
the end was coming,
and if he looked it in the eye, then he would die.
That is the Owl Man Morning. He's real.
Mrs. Boyd, the Owl Man is a figment of Virgil's imagination. Please, do not start telling him it's real.
Oh, but I tell no fib, Doctor. Creature's been sighted again, so there you know. Sylvia Crab of Tregasco saw it in the water in her back garden. And then, oh, Dick Cutter. He was driving up Harley, you know, and just flew out across his window. They lived to tell the tale, but Grace Pucky weren't so lucky. She died.
Shut your eyes, keep them closed against the night. If the owlman sees you, then you're sure to die of fright.
And lo, the owlman cometh, harbinger of doom, angel of death. Upon his flight, the earth will choke,
and the light will suffer once more.
Dark days are ahead. Dark days indeed.
Well, lad.
Well, come on, lad.
I've got you these. They're fresh and I bought them off.
I'll put some in bin there.
Has much changed? Did you go out? How does it feel to be back?
Strange. Married. Again.
That's so hard to believe.
No. Well, that's wonderful news, Mother. You know, I'm happy with for you. What with Father being gone so long and all, and do you know, I'm over the moon for you. So, who is the lucky fella?
Well, that's the thing, see, you know him of old.
Do I?
Do you have any idea who he might be?
Not a clue, no.
Is an old school coming over?
It's my age.
I'll bring him down for you.
Okay, is he now though?
Of course he's fucking here, where else would he be as my husband, you twat? Dusty! Dusty, darling, Virgil's here!
Dusty!
Saw your mother on telly last night. In a fucking porno.
Oh, Dusty!
You rest when you're in, don't you?
Yeah, I'm Dusty. Yeah.
Except I was the last fellow who was expecting you married to your mother living in the house, ever.
You married Dusty?
Well, she said yes.
Yeah, well, this happened
now. Oh, don't ask me.
I was doing your windows, wasn't I, sweet pea?
Windows, you was.
You needed a refit.
This is all Dusty's work.
For some hot that August holiday was.
Dusty's that angry to amazing, you know.
Well, there's an outfit there. Let no prick ask what Chase Ford to tell the other one.
Sledgehammered the old damn wall down, ain't it?
Well, that's advice, Virgil. Don't use linseed out of the thing. It's your rubber sealing, causes pretty much all misty, and then you're fucked.
I wanted
to introduce you to the regular store and consent. And I had a summer deal on install now, getting our price.
So I took the opportunity to call him up, get him in.
Well, I thought I'd run into you, Virgil, but of course he was up in bottom in loony bin.
And as I was sat there watching his little ass skip about,
as I said, his heart was out.
His bronze shoulders were slick with sweat.
Well, in no way was that meant to be a come-on.
I was struck. The beautiful idea.
This is the way I look at you.
I thought Dusty is double glazing is amazing. And it should be in every house in Nantucket. Nantucket and beyond that, sir.
Well, that's the thing. I never got time to chase people up.
So, I thought maybe Dusty could get on and do double glazing. I'll come along with an administrative crutch.
Well, all the while, thinking to myself, brimming all the windows, I don't remember Mrs. Bly looking that good.
So, got up off my chair, and I shimmied on over to him, and I looked him dead in the
eye. And me, I go all weak in my knees.
Can't make a business props position.
And I propose marriage.
Here we are, in business.
In love.
Partners in crime, eh?
Some hot that August holiday was.
So, that's how it happened anyway.
Oh, I've got to tell you something. We're like you, playing to glass, you know, trapping the 8 night that Venus had hit, did it ride up. Oh, we got a lot of trap there that Venus spurred. This woman, she's perfect for me. Digs all the things I dig, like Bob Marley, smoking spliffs, and getting jiggy and eating cheese and smoking spliffs.
And you know, you can dance to this one.
Such a dream. But it was shat upon, wouldn't it, dear?
Oh,
wanking in a coffee tool.
That
means some asshole nurse is something off with me semen. She said my semen was lazy, look. She said my semen was lazy.
As you can see, the fact that we could not conceive was causing
heavy strains on this relationship.
And on business too.
I was in a funk.
He lost all his work.
I got sloppy with my installations.
Started losing custom.
It felt like I had my balls chopped off or something.
Now, I've worked very hard to get this scheme together. And I'll be damned if I was going to let it slip through my fingers.
She saved me.
So, when Dr. Fucking Levine calls up saying that you're sane enough to come home.
Oh, this is interesting.
I got to thinking. Well, my Dusty's all dysfunctional because he can't fulfill his dreams about a kid. Business about to go tits up. And then this doctor calls me and tells me that I've got this son that I near enough forgot about.
Could they both somehow?
Well, Bert, you have to understand, I never wanted you back, not in any way. But I was prepared to make the sacrifice.
You hear that? Your mother is fucking sane.
So there you are. I thought, Verge, it'll do.
Yeah, Dusty got a baby now. Sure, we went to school and all that bullshit, but in the eyes of the law, I am your dad.
So, here you are.
What do you make of that? Insane, innit?
Insane?
Well, Dusty got a baby, Dusty's daddy now. I want to teach you all of this, you know, like, teach you how to kick a ball around. Teach you how to stand your ground, because from what I remember, you weren't much fucking cop back in the days, were you? Anyway, I'm so happy. Are you happy, Pupcake?
Oh, I'm happy if you're happy.
Oh, I'm so busted happy. I got me son me joy when new team boy. If I'm happy, you're happy. That just leaves Virgil. You happy, Virgil?
Oi, Virgil. Are you Virgil?
Virgil.
Oi, Clothies. Are you happy or not?
Don't look at me. Where are you going? Oh, I'm going back to Bobby.
Not going anywhere. Best do what I tell you. They'll be trouble.
Thank you. Well, I'm ready when you are.
kind of independent apocalypse. If the shadow looks you in the eye, it's dead as a doorknob. It's taking poor old Liz for cure, Daddy.
Yes, so I've heard.
Number of folks in the village have seen him, and I don't want to be next. That's what I'm making fast for me getaway.
To another planet?
I've been in contact with several alien civilizations for a while now. They owe me a favor or two. Besides, there is nothing left for me here, and I don't want them. Hi, your tippy toes!
How many call you?
Find that fence there.
Find
the fence there!
Released the drawings they made. The drawings of what they thought they'd see.
Blood Brother!
At first I was afraid, I was petrified. You're thinking I could never live without you by my side. But there are spits on me tonight, thinking how you've been wrong.
Five in the lock, one up, you know it.
Shut the door.
Yeah. Are you fucking stupid?
What?
Don't you dare speak about this stuff in front of Virgil. You'll blow everything.
You started it.
Huh? Did I? I was being discreet. Hence use of the word recalcitrant.
And why did you do a mockery of my trade?
How?
By calling you dumb.
Dusty. Double glazing with dumb. Ain't no bones about it.
This is science, it's an art.
Oh, Christ.
You also undermine my authority back there.
What authority?
My authority. My authority over Virgil. I'm getting the boy to respect me.
And then kick shit out of him like he used to do.
I can't beat my own son.
Stepson.
As much as I'd love to go back to the old days, it won't be right. Just don't make me look stupid again.
Well, you don't need me to do that, do you? Thank you.
What was he saying?
He's going off and in a head again, like he did 10 years ago.
Oh, Dusty's always here.
Oh, doesn't I know it?
Forgot how much I enjoy tracking him anyway.
I bet.
So?
So, get that peach of an ass of yours up those stairs. Come on, bring Bob too.
I'll bring Bob if you bring Nancy.
Oh, and if she goes wherever I go, don't you die. Come on!
Over to Nancy.
Dr. Levine, it's Virgil here. If you get this medicine, could you come and get me? Things aren't working out so well at the moment. I'd really like to go back to Bob and
thank you.
do.
I have been to they spoke to me in an alien tongue that I could strangely understand. Fun fact, they told me that Sally's bottom was one of the 12 hiding sites.
I'm trying to prove to Virgil that Sally's bottom has no significance whatsoever.
Well,
tell them the link that comes for you. What she said.
Just like that, the business took off. We started making money. We saw this bright future. And now it's all over because of you fucking shitheads. Still gonna add up, though.
I can't believe it. This legal stuff.
Well, I wear the proper gear. There's loads of it strung around.
Bastards who dump this dump. Everything. Perhaps they had to leave in a hurry. That's still my excuse. Well, it's no excuse, but it's also no great conspiracy. The more the state goes on, the more normal it gets.
Wouldn't say that, Iris. Look at the name tag on these overcoats.
What does it mean?
I don't know. But I have a small feeling that my conspiracy spreading. Bully marrying, psychopathic, Rastafarian mother man. Come on, let's go.
Hey! Ah! And they
going to punish.
But Greg stuck it. Well, you can't pin her death on me. That weren't me. That was the owl man. He's the one you want. I'm just sell double glaze, isn't it?
What?
Yeah, well, I found his work clothes underground, mother. It was old and rotted, but still made count the name tag on him. Alfred Floyd.
We do not speak that name in this house. How many times have I had to tell you? Take this off! Take it off now!
No. Those chemicals were dumped when the factory closed in 1976.
During the summer of weirdness?
Right before Virgil was born.
I know you know what happened. Just tell me. I just want to know the truth.
I recognise you.
Oh, God.
You're that Roscoe girl. You were some of my sons 10 years ago, weren't you? I was. And the sweet of my husband 1 year ago.
Actually, I don't put down the door before.
Stop that.
That's not how I remember it. Dusty told me everything. He told me you were heartbroken.
He did not, did he?
Aye. Didn't he, Nancy? He told me how you used to send him letters, all covered in stars and glitter and shit.
The things I know about my dad, well, but I dug it myself, so...
But Neil?
Yeah, okay, with Iris' help, 10 years ago, but I never got to the bottom of it. I mean, Dr. Levine reckons that if I knew what happened of that man, I never knew, I might be able to bring some demons to rest.
Right.
You'd help me, Mother. Greatly help me if you could just tell me what became of him. I know you know what happened, so just tell me, please.
Thanks, boy. Please.
You've not forgiven them for us.
I can't believe you betrayed me like this, Dusty.
But what I think betraying was hard luck I got caught, that's all.
You got sloppy again.
Can we please get back to Bertha?
No, shut up, Bobby. This is more important.
This ain't no good, Dusty.
What do you mean this ain't no good? Where do we go from here?
Nowhere. That's it. Finito. There ain't no tomorrow for us, Dusty.
No, that can't be right. Come on. Forgive me, eh?
No. I will not.
What? Mm-hmm. Ben? You serious? Come on, look at me.
No, Dusty.
Oh, yes.
Why don't you work anymore?
I don't need it.
Look at me. Come on.
I've taken from you everything that I need.
No.
My fascination for you's waned.
Oh, God, why?
Because, just it said today, you fucked up. You fucked up for stupid. You are.
I'm not stupid.
You are.
Oi, don't.
Hey, don't you dare to put me again. I handed you this business on a plate. You squandered it all through downright fucking stupidity.
But it's my business. Oh. These hands installed the windows.
Not
yours.
Oh, not this again.
Well, that's what we agree.
Oh, no. We agreed to keep this whole thing a secret till the day that we died.
Well, I made a mistake. I'm sorry.
A mistake? You fucking blew the whole thing, Dusty. You ruined everything. Just like he did. And just like his father did before him. I can't stand it. You're all so weak of mind. Timid as rabbits. Blown off course by the slightest breeze. Can't stand this. Auspices of blood. The lot of you.
Don't you auspices of blood me.
What?
That's enough. That's way out of light.
Auspices of blood! Auspices of blood! Auspices of blood!
That's enough now. That's one step too far. Just stop.
Why? Don't want to make a fool of yourself in front of your stepson.
Well, son.
Is that what you're saying now?
Stepson. Virgil, I ain't your dad.
I know.
Well, I've never pretended to be one.
You have!
Well, I won't anymore then, you're lost! I may have put you through hell as a child, but it's that time you make amends. Tell him what he needs to know.
So you start.
You tell him where I will.
Eh? You don't even know what happened, you weren't even born.
Right, I can't tell you what happened.
Help me, Mother.
I will not!
I know you know what happened.
Just tell him this is Chloe.
Please, why should I?
Because he's your fucking son. You lied to him all his life. Just tell him.
Tell me, Mother. What's wrong with him?
I put my scanner
through. Yeah! I guess so!
Christ almighty, what's going on?
No, no!
You do it.
Virgil,
you wouldn't. What's his hand? Is it always too nice?
Yes, it's the air. Which one is the
They're all not the
whole. You've got the whole house, you idiot!
You're jealous, no!
I'm gonna do it! I will!
Just tell him it's all.
Where's the key?
No escape.
No place is airtime.
Bloody double Gracie.
Tell me, Mother.
Why?
Well, because I'm going to do it. I will. I ain't joking.
I know you are, boy. You've got that same determined look in your eyes you had more than a year ago. But, I ain't afraid to die. And you take with me some fucking secrets to be great.
But it's not just you who will be dying.
Well, there ain't no one in here that's too good for a gas in, you mean.
What? Even Nancy? You know me, Mother. No one ever liked her.
I know you haven't, you vicious shit!
I can't be guessing. All of us see that aberration lines for rest.
How can you say such things? She's your sister!
She's not my sister, she's a sis!
People
know my name!
She's not a thing!
It's a foul, disgusting whore.
She is not a love. You fucker! How dare you! Dusty, get him! It's him hard now, go! You're an asshole!
Tell me, Mother!
Go to her!
We'll all go to hell together!
Wait! I tried to get away, Virgil, but it
without even thinking. Aye. To that, gave birth, and here we are. Now then, I suggest that we get on and do the same thing with Dustin before anyone starts asking any questions. Come on, give me an hand.
No more secrets, Mother.
It was said it began as a bedtime story.
children of the village suite.
You best think of the skull now, girl.
The owl will come for you. It was said that the mere sight of the fiend were a sign of terrible things in the whole world. It was said that when the owl man came, he cast his shadow over the land. You knew the end were near. But it was worse still. The monster looked you square in the eye. Because their death had been coming for you. Swift and sure.
Shut your eyes. Keep them closed against the night. The helmet sees you, then you're sure to die of fright.
That's what I believed anyway.
I'm Nino Benino badge. Doesn't help.
Oh, man.